Greetings to you, my people. My name is Ambassador Ayegba, Abdullahi, Adojoh, the General Igala Ambassador, Eju Igala, Attah of Igala Kingdom. I am a researcher and a historian. I am also the National and International Coordinator of Igala People Discovery and Reconnection Project of Attah Igala. Today, I want us to discuss briefly on the topic Achadu, as well as the role of Achadu Kata in Igala Kingdom. The term Achadu literally means one who assigns the workers or servants their duties or task. Attah Igala is the king of Igala people. Attah stays in the palace, even though not always. But Attah has enough work or enough issues to attend to in the palace. And so he needed, there was no much time for him for the coordination of his farmers, hunters, fishermen, various maybe warriors, as well as the supervision of some of his territories outside, either or far away from either. So there was need for an assistant or one who assist him in some of these things. And that was what brought the idea of Achadu Okata. Of course, the Achadu Okata is the replication or the replica of what we had in ancient Egypt, where Igala ruled for 90 years, between 2130 BC to 2040 BC as Pharaoh of the 10th dynasty. Yes, in those days, after Pharaoh, there was an assistant, and he was termed Vizier. The Vizier was the prime minister of the ancient Pharaoh. He was like an assistant to Pharaoh. The highest ranking official in the Pharaoh Royal Council. His functions were many, but the summary of it is that he was in charge of the supervision of the running or day-to-day running of the Egypt nation. That is what exactly the Achadu is still doing or was meant to do with other roles. The first Achadu Okata was Omepajogo. The person, he was called Achadu Okata because, which simply means Achadu, the husband of Attah Igala. So this is because the Attah Igala then was a female, Amishi, popularly called a Bulejon, the daughter of Abuteje. Abuteje was the Attah who ruled after Olema too. Why Olema ruled after Agoji? This and those, these are the pre-Abuteje Attahs. So when the Amishi became the Attah, she married Omepa, the son of Ajugu. And according to the ancient Egyptian culture too, when anyone married a queen, the person will automatically become the king, a king or a title holder. And that was how Omepa became a title holder. And in this case, Achadu, the prime minister of Igala Kingdom. So, and he was also to assist her in overseeing the day-to-day running of the Igala nation. Until date, Achadu is still doing that work. So, presently, now that our own Attah, Idakwa Ogoni, has gone hunting, the second in command, who is the Achadu, is now in charge of the entire Igala nation. The first Achadu, like I've said, was Omepa Ajogu, the son of Onogu Ajoga Opalua Inyong. These people are aware of Igaloba clan. The Igaloba clan were known as Anu people. The Anu people migrated from Egypt. Okay, the record is also there. They're of ancient Egypt. Egyptian people, they all came with other Igala groups. So when they came, stayed in the place they call Atagara in Borno State, from there to Atagara in Kwarafara, then to Ida. And when they came, they were the first two groups. They came along with the Igaloba, the Igala Mela people. When Igala Mela stayed at Opata, the Anu people stayed at the front, Ejuoba. So that is why they are called Igala Oba people. So till date, Achadu Okata is still playing a traditional role in the making of a new Attah, especially as the traditional husband of Attah. So this is just the brief about the title Achadu when it started and some of the functions or roles of Achadu. So more videos are coming. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, United Igala Kingdom TV. It's on YouTube. Just after watching, just click on subscribe. It will make the video to go and educate more people. God bless you.